So you have Postman, you have Salesforce, and you want to connect Postman and Salesforce so that you can access Salesforce API through Postman, right? So in this video, that's what I'm going to show you, how you can configure your Postman to access Salesforce API and finally to access Salesforce data. Hey everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. Okay, so here I am in my Salesforce developer org. So the first thing that you need to do, you need to open a Salesforce developer org. If you don't have that, please go and open that, because that's the first thing. Once you have opened your Salesforce developer org, you open your Postman, and I'm going to open my Postman. So here is my Postman. So I'll create a new workspace. So here, let me create a workspace as Postman, Salesforce together. You can keep the visibility as it is and create workspace. Once this is done, you need to open the Salesforce developer workspace. It's a public workspace where Salesforce keep on updating all the APIs. The link I'll provide in the description of this video, but this is how it will look like. This link I'll provide in the description of this video. So once you open that, what you need to do, you need to click on this Salesforce platform API, click on that, and then click on this fork. Then choose the workspace that you have created. For example, I just created Postman Salesforce together workspace. So I select that and click on fork collection. And once this is done, I'm going to close this browser window. And then in my Postman, I can see I have all the APIs. What I need to do, I need to authorize, or I need to connect my Salesforce org with this Postman. So for that, I'll click on this at the top level, Salesforce platform. Make sure on the top right, no environment is selected, and click on this authorization. From the type, select OAuth2. You may find multiple options, but select OAuth2. Keep rest everything as it is and click on get new access token. The moment you click on that, it will open your org in the browser window. I have already logged in. That's why it's asking me to allow or deny. I'll just go ahead and click on allow. If you are not logged in, it will ask you to provide your username and password. You provide your username and password for the developer org, and then it will ask you whether you really want to allow or deny. Click on allow. And then it will ask another prompt, open Postman. And then authorization is done. New access token is received by Postman. This is a new access token. Let me put a name as my new token. One important thing on this window, from this window, copy this instance URL and click on use token. Then this page will come here. You click on this variable tab. And at the endpoint, you have initial value and the current value. So for the endpoint, under current value, paste the URL that you have copied just a few minutes back, and then click on save. And all your configuration is done. Now let's go and test that. So for testing purpose, expand this REST API and click on limits. It's going to show all the limits from this developer org. And you don't need to change anything, just click on send. And it will show you all the limits from the org. And it proves that our connectivity is done. Our Postman is already configured to connect with our developer org. One thing that you can do, for example, if you go to the SObject and describe, and here it's a get call. Here SObject name, API name, you can just put any API name. For example, I put contact and then click on send. It will provide the contact object details. Similarly, you can create records for that SObject create, and it's a post call. SObject name, for example, I want to create an account. So I'll put the SObject name as account. Under the body, so for the name, I'll put as Technical Potpourri. All done. So what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to create an account in my developer org with the name as Technical Potpourri. Click on send. It's going to create an account. Here is the account ID. Now if I go to my org and click on account, I'll find there is a new account being created, Technical Potpourri. So this is the way how you can configure your Postman to access Salesforce data through Salesforce API. I hope this short video is helpful. Please hit the like icon, share, and please subscribe to my channel to get update about all my upcoming videos. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.